hand is lying all the way back. Way down. Let's put the soles of the feet kind of together. Just open your knees out wide. Maybe rest one hand on your belly, one on your heart. Just be heavy here for a moment. Close your eyes and just start to deepen your breath. And just begin to arrive. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Deep breath in. And deep breath out. More inhale here. And exhale. Let's bring the knees together. Plant both feet on your mat, knees pointed up. Let's do a morning stretch from here. Both legs straight out. Let's reach long to the fingertips and toes. Stretch it out. And release the stretch. Soles of the feet coming back down to the mat here. Just extend the right leg to the ceiling and just cross that right ankle over that left knee for figure four stretch. And from here, just reach the right hand through and between the legs. Let's wrap that left hand around the hamstring as well. Just bind the hands. Pull that hamstring into the chest. Just let the hips be heavy. Feel that stretch in the sacrum and your outer hip. Just kind of soften your shoulders down to the mat. Soften your face. And release the right leg. Let's return both feet back to the mat. Let's try this on the other side, figure four, other side. Cross the left ankle over the right knee. Let's weave the left hand in between the legs. Grab that hamstring with both palms. Relax back. Draw the hamstring in. Soften your hips. Soften your face. Chest. Good, so let's find a cat pose with the spine. Just round the mat, bring the arms forward into parallel with the mat. Reach the arms up again, breath in. Find a cow spine so heart lifts. And then exhale, round. Hands pressing forward. Spine pulling back. Let's raise the arms up again. Inhale. Flow the pubic bone down into your mat. And breath out, cat spine. Move the pubic bone away from the floor as you round the back. And another inhale, arms up, chest up. And exhale, the hands down, back to your easy seat. Just keep your spine neutral here while you sit. And let's find a tabletop position. So we're gonna roll over our shins and place the palms down under your shoulders and knees under your hips. Lateral spinal stretch from here. We'll let the spine become neutral here. Take a breath in. As you exhale, let's move the right shoulder and the right hip towards one another. Almost like you're making a letter C with your body. Just gazing over your right shoulder. And inhale, come back to the center. Exhale, squeeze the left shoulder this time and left hip together. And pass the left shoulder. And breathe in, coming back to your center. Exhale, C-shape to the right. And breathe in, pass through your center again. Exhale, C-shape left. Take a few more rounds on your own. Just wagging your tail. Yeah. Return to our neutral spine, back to your tabletop, palms over the shoulders. Let's try a kneeling plantar stretch. Inhale, bring the knees together to touch. Tuck your toes behind you. Now as you breathe out, let's guide the hips back onto your heels. Now you can keep the hands on the floor here if you'd like, or slowly start to sit upright and bring the hands to your thighs. Just inhale deeply here. This good stretch can get a little intense, so adjust the pressure. The hips on the heels if you need to. Just take a breath out as you soften your jaw. Again, breath in. And exhale. One more inhale. And exhale. Slowly make our way back to our tabletop. Walk the hands to the mat here. Untuck your toes. Let's tuck the toes again one more time. Take a deep breath in here. And exhale from here. Let's find our downward dog. We're just lifting the hips up and back. And rooting down through the palms here. Letting your biceps frame your ears as you push the mat forward. Just taking a deep breath in here. Softening through the shoulders on that breath out. If you want to pedal your feet, let's do that. Soften the ankles towards the mat. Your back release and your shoulder stretch. As you flex your quads, bending your tailbone high to the sky. Take a breath in here. Deepen the stretch in the hamstrings. As you soften the ankles, let the heels fall towards the floor. Take a breath out. Push through the hands and keep your tail high. Take a breath in, soften the shoulders, ankles, breath out. Let's inhale to plank from here. Shift your shoulders over your wrist here. Just lifting up onto your tippy toes. Engage in your core. You can drop the knees here if you need to. Exhale from here. Slowly lower down to your belly. Keep your hips high as you lower. Got it. Chest and hips. Hitting the ground at the same time. Inhale to cobra. Let's bring the hips down to the mat from here. Lift the chest off the ground. And we're warming up the back here. Keep the chest lifted as you breathe out. Just roll the shoulders back and down. Look down at the mat. One more breath in here. Maybe lift the chin again. Let your back do the work. Keep your torso lifted. Exhale. Let's lower back down. Chest back down to the mat. Plant the hands on the mat here, just under your shoulders. Let's inhale, tuck the back toes, push yourself back up to tabletop position. And from here, back to downward dog. Let's lift the knees off the ground and send the hips up and back. Just kind of push through your hands here as you inhale. Soften the ankles to the ground. If you want to pedal the feet here for a moment, do that. Just exhale. And let's send that right foot up and back for three-legged dog. Keep the foot pointing straight down at your mat. Your right hip pointing towards your mat. Feel stretch in the left hamstring. Maybe in that right hip flexor. Exhale. Let's find a low lunge. Shift the shoulders forward. And just step the foot in between the palms. Pull that knee up into your chest as you plant the right foot down between the palms. Take a breath in here. Kind of gaze forward. Exhale. Let's find a forward fold. Step that left foot forward to meet the other. And inhale for halfway lift. From your hands into your shins for a moment. Keep your spine long. Exhale. Let's fold forward all the way back down. And inhale. Circle sweep the arms up to the sky. And exhale. Spill over your legs. Back down. And inhale. Find that halfway lift again. Press the hands into your quads, shins, or floor. And exhale. Let's plant the palms and step back to downward facing dog. And from here, inhale, shift forward to your plank, shoulders over the wrist. Exhale, chaturanga this time. If you'd like to try it, pinch forward on those tippy toes, halfway down with the elbows. Lower the knees if you need to. Just lower the chest halfway down. And inhale, upward facing dog. Let's roll the toes down, tops of the feet to the mat. Straighten the elbows. Just lifting the shoulders high as you roll them back and down. Pushing down through the feet, keeping the legs engaged, sit off the mat. Exhale, downward facing dog. Flip the feet back over, send the hips up and back. And inhale from here, let's bring that left foot up and back this time for three-legged dog. Push down through your hands and create length, driving that left foot away from you. Exhale, find your low lunge, shift forward, shoulders over the wrist, step the left foot forward. Round the spine, pull that knee up into your chest. Left foot down between the hands. Take a breath in here and gaze to the top of the mat. And exhale, let's find our forward fold. Step that right foot to meet the left. And inhale, lift up halfway. And exhale, fold it back down. And Urdhva Hastasana. Let's inhale and circle sweep those arms up tall. Soften the shoulders down your back. Exhale, swan dive forward. And inhale to a halfway lift. And exhale, let's bring that left foot back. Low lunge. And let's open up to a warrior two from here. Spiral that back heel down to the mat. Breathe in. Keep that front knee bent. And rise up. Open the arms out wide. And up. Exhale, settle in. Knees beyond your right hand. Arms out to a T. Take a breath in. Just reaching through the fingertips. Just kind of deepening the bend in that front knee. Feeling the heat build as you exhale. And inhale, peaceful warrior. Reach the palm forward and lift the palm. Lift it up to the sky. Bring the torso back. Just feel the stretch in your side body. Landing that back hand on the back leg. Let it slide down as you continue to tilt the torso back. Exhale. Reaching your fingertips higher to the sky. Take a big breath in. And exhale. Extended side angle. Let's keep the legs how they are. Just rest that front arm on the front thigh. Got it. Other arm reaching along the ear. Just sweeping the left arm up and over. Along the ear. Deep breath in here. Stretching the fingertips away. Just creating one long line from the fingertips all the way down to that left foot. Deep in the bend in that front knee. Take a breath out. Still stretching the front inner thigh. Rotating the chest upward towards the ceiling. Turning the gaze to the ceiling. Take an inhale here. And exhale. Feel the heat build on the front thigh. Rotating the chest up. Inhale. Lock down, deep. Deep in that lunge. One last time. down this time. Take one breath here as you lift it up. And exhale, find your low lunge. Windmill the hands down. Frame that front foot on your mat. Lift up that back heel. Push through the hands and round your spine. Just lifting the knee towards the chest. Feel the core engage here. Take a breath in here. Exhale, step that front foot back and find your downward dog. And inhale from here, shift forward to your plank, rolling forward on your mat. Exhale, chaturanga, lower halfway down, elbows going straight back. And you got it, inhale, upward facing dog, open the chest. Exhale to down dog, let's lift up from your core, bringing the hips up and back. Inhale on the tippy toes. Let's bend the knees deeply, just kind of gaze forward. And exhale, step or fly to the top of your mat. And inhale, let's lift up halfway. And exhale, fold it down. Chair pose from here. Let's bend those knees and sink the hips back and down. Inhale, bring the arms overhead. And just kind of stay in the pose as you exhale. Shifting the weight back into your heels. Bending the knees a little deeper, just letting the heat build in the thighs. Inhale, lift the arms a little higher. The palms to face each other. Got it. And fold forward all the way down. Take a breath out here. Inhale for a halfway lift. And exhale. Let's step the right foot back this time and find our low lunge. Open up to warrior two on this side. So we're going to spin that back heel down to the mat. Inhale, rise up first. Windmill the arms out wide when you're ready to a T. And just breathe out here. Deepen the bend in that front knee. Soft gaze past your hand. Just shifting the front knee a bit to the left. Opening the hips. Inhale here. Relax your shoulders down as you exhale. And let's inhale a peaceful warrior. Flip that front palm and sweep it up to the sky. Send it up and back. And take a breath out here. And sliding back down that back leg. Feeling the side body stretch. Just reaching straight up to the ceiling. Inhale here. And exhale for extended side angle. Legs stay the same. We're just tilting forward, placing the left elbow on the left thigh, and sweeping the other arm along here. Right arm along here. A straight line to the length of the right side. Inhale here. Deepen the bend in that front knee if you can. Exhale. Just lengthening the stance here. Rotating the chest up to the ceiling. Inhale. Feel the heat building the legs as we breathe out. Rotating the chest. One more inhale. Deep in the lunge. One last time. Exhale. Let's go back to peaceful warrior. Left arm to the sky again. One breath in here. And then exhale to your low lunge. Cartwheel those hands down. Let's lift up that back heel. And again, pushing through the hands. Core is engaged. Just try to suck that knee into your chest in front. Inhale. Exhale, let's step it back to downward dog. And inhale, let's come high into the tippy toes. Bend the knees, look towards your hands here. Towards the front of the room. Exhale, let's make our way to the top of the mat. And inhale for a halfway lift up. And exhale, folding it down. Inhale, surface sweep those arms up to the sky. Spend our Urdhva Hastasana. And exhale, come into the Tadasana, standing tall, your palms facing forward. Let's try some standing balance, tree pose. Now shifting the weight to your right foot, let's connect the sole of the left foot to the ankle, the calf, or you can reach down and press the sole of the foot on the inner thigh. Just be sure to place the foot above or below the knee to prevent stressing that knee joint. When you're ready, float the hands to heart center, and just breathe out here as you rest the eyes on a single point of the focus. Breathe in as you grow taller, standing foot rooting down. Anchor that standing foot down to the mat. Exhale. Stand tall, shoulders aligned over your hips, tailbone down. Inhale, lift through the crown of the head. And let's move back to Tadasana. Breathe out. Turn the foot to the mat. Standing tall again. Arms in by your sides. Palms facing forward. Let's try this on the other side. Tree pose. Shifting the weight to the left foot this time. Let's place the sole of the right foot, the ankle, the calf. Or if you want to clear the knee joint, use your hand. Place the foot to the inner thigh. When you're ready, just join the hands together at heart center. And breathe out. Keep the eyes focused ahead. As you move the shoulders back just a touch. Standing foot down. Lift up through the standing leg and just breathe in here. Let the breath go. Soften your shoulders away from your ears. Relaxing, firming the palms into one another. Inhale. And back to Tadasana. Exhale. Foot down to the mat. Arms down by your sides again. Palms facing forward here. Concentrating on the breath. Let's inhale, start to sweep the arms to the sky. And soften your knees and spill forward. Forward fold. Inhale for a halfway lift. And exhale, let's plant the palms and step back to bend elbows, chaturanga. And up dog from here. Inhale, straighten the elbows. And exhale, down dog. Let's lift up from the core here. Press back. And inhale, bend the knees, look forward again. Getting ready to make our way forward. Exhale, step or float to the top of the mat. And inhale, lift up halfway. And exhale, fold it forward. Virabhasana. Inhale, surface root those arms tall overhead. Soften the shoulders down your back. And exhale, spill down again over the legs. Chair pose from here, bend the knees. Inhale, reach the arms overhead. And just keep the deep bend in the knees here. Exhale, hands to heart center. And inhale here to lengthen through your spine. And exhale, let's revolve this. Rotate the torso towards the right. Just connect that left elbow to the outside edge of the right thigh. Take the gaze over your right shoulder. Breath in here. As you press the palms firmly together, just finding more length through your spine. Take a breath out. Twist even more, pushing the tricep into the thigh, and then thigh back into the tricep. Take a breath in, press the palms firmly together, and breathe out, just twisting even more. And forward, but let's release slowly and long. Release completely forward down. Just be heavy for a moment. Maybe sway from side to side. Neutralize the hips a little bit. And inhale to a halfway lift. And exhale. Let's bring the left foot back for a low lunge. An easy twist from here. Keep everything where it is. Let's just peel this right arm up to the side, to the sky. Take a big breath in as you reach up. And exhale, try to rotate the right hip down towards the ground, twisting deeper. Reaching through the hand, just rotating the chest to the sky. Big inhale here. Let's find our corkscrew. If you want, go ahead and lower that back knee down, left knee down. Turn the right toes out a little bit here, knee coming out wide. And then you open out to the side. Bend that back knee if you like. And let's pull that heel in towards the glute. Just reach the right hand back and capture the foot with the right hand. And let the chest stay open to the side. Hips are descending down to the front of your mat. Now, if this is too much, just stay here with the arm lifted. Just twist to the side. Work on your twist. You should feel this in the back thigh if you're using that. Corkscrew pose here. Front of the back thigh. So if you guys have yoga straps, sometimes those are helpful for these poses. Because you can look around your foot, just pull the length that you need. When I'm rich, I'm gonna buy you also. Yeah, I'll be rich now. again. Release that back foot down. Unwind. Let's put the hands frame that front foot on your mat again. Tuck the back toes under. Let's lift that back knee up. Just press through the hands. Inhale here. And exhale. Let's step that front foot back and find your downward dog. And inhale. Let's lift our hands here. Soft into the knees. Again, prepare to move forward. Exhale. Let's step or hop to the top of the mat. And inhale. Lift up halfway. And exhale. Fold it back down. Inhale. Let's circle sweep the arms up to the sky. Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, swan dive forward, all the way back down. Let's find our chair pose, bend the knees. Inhale, sweep the arms up, tall overhead. And exhale, stay seated deeply in chair. Let's draw the hands to our heart center. And inhale as you open the chest. And exhale, from here, let's revolve it. Going to the other side this time, twisting left. Hook that right tricep, outside edge of the left thigh. Just take the gaze over to the left shoulder. As you breathe out, press the palms together even more. Just grow long in your spine. Keep the weight back in your heels. Breathe out here, just twisting more. Firming the tricep into the thigh. And the thigh back into the tricep. Inhale here, just get longer in the spine. And breathe out as you twist a little more. And back to your forward fold, slowly unwind. Put the hands drop to the ground as the toes. Drape the torso over the legs, relax the head and neck. And then if you want to sway the hips side to side. And inhale, let's find a halfway lift. And exhale, let's bring that right foot back this time for low lunge. An easy twist on the other side. Let's keep the legs firmly into the mat here. And just inhale as you lift the left arm this time up to the ceiling. Finding your twist, just staying in the pose as you exhale. Just gotta keep the left hand where it is. As you rotate that left hip down to face your mat. One more inhale here. Just keep reaching tall, gazing up at the left fingertips. Let's find our core too. If you want, lower that right knee down. Left knee open out to the side a little bit here. Left toes kind of pointing outwards again. Just reach the left arm back and capture the back foot. Pull that right heel in towards your glute. Let the hips descend towards the front of the mat. And just feel the opening in the right hip flexor. Step it back and find your downward dog. And inhale, shift forward to plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Lowering halfway down. And inhale to up dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Let's find child's pose from here. Bring the big toes together to touch. Separate the knees out wide. Let the tops of the feet come down to your mat. Just press the hips back and down. Just resting towards your heels or on your heels. Completely relax. Everything that was just working. Resting your forehead into the mat. Just breathe deeply here. Let's start hands to behind us, pointing the fingers forward and pushing the chest forward. Knees are outstretched. Lift the hips to the sky. Let the gaze come up slightly. And let the head hang back if you want. Exhale. Inhale to push the hips forward. Just pushing the chest forward. Rolling the shoulders back. And let's find our down dog from here. Walk the palms forward. Let's lift the hips up to the sky. Once we're here, we're going to lift that right leg up to the sky. Three-legged dog. And exhale to low lunge. Step the right foot forward. Keep that back leg engaged. Straightening that back knee. Let's find a crescent lunge. Lower that back knee down. Let's reach the arms up here. Back knee is down to the mat. Draining the ears with the biceps. Take a big breath in here. And a breath out as you lean into the stretch. That hip flexor. Hips pushing forward and down. Last breath in. Gazing forward and up. Hands high. Exhale, hands to heart center. And inhale, let's lengthen the spine here. So let's revolve this as well. Crescent twist to the right. Hook that left tricep, outside edge of the knee. Outside of that right thigh. Take the gaze over your right shoulder. Inhale here, find more length through the spine. Square your crown bone away from your tailbone. As you breathe out, just deepen into the twist. Drawing your right ribcage back. Wrapping the left ribs around to the front. Long spine with each breath in. And exhale, just a little bit deeper. If you follow the pose, it's okay. Ready, get right back into it. Let's find a low lunge. Gently unwind here. Bring the hands down to the mat here. Tuck the back toes under. Let's raise that back knee up. Inhale here. And exhale. Let's step the foot back. Find your downward dog. And inhale, let's bring that left leg to the sky. Three-legged dog, other side. And exhale, find your low lunge. Step that foot between the palms. Crescent lunge, lower that back knee down to the mat. Let's bring the arms overhead, big breath in at the top. As you exhale, push the hips forward and down. Feel the opening in the right hip flexor. Last inhale, reaching tall. And exhale, the hands to prayer. Inhale, open the chest, lengthen our spine. Exhale, let's revolve this as well. Other side, twist towards the left this time. Connect the right tricep, outer edge of the left thigh, gazing beyond your left shoulder. Just take a breath in, go longer from the top of the head, down to the tail. And as you breathe out, deepen into that twist. And draw the left rib cage back, just wrapping the right ribs forward. And breathing in here, keeping your spine long. Stay in the twist for one more breath out. And let's go to low lunge, slowly in line. Bring the hands to frame that front foot on your mat. Let's tuck the back toes, lift that back knee up. And engage your core here, inhale. Exhale, let's step it back. Downward facing dog. And inhale to your plank, shifting forward on your mat. Chaturanga. Exhale. And inhale, upward facing dog. And exhale, downward dog. Let's find an easy seat. Lower the knees down to your mat and just swing the legs around in front of you. Crisscross. Let's try our boat pose for our cores here. We're going to extend the heels and the feet down to the mat and extend the arms long in front, palms facing forward. Engage your cores, lean back slightly as you lift your feet. Let the shins come parallel to the floor. And inhale here. Just keep drawing your belly in. If it's too much, you can always bring the hands back down to the shins or even the hamstrings for more support. And exhale, soften the shoulders away from your ears. The chest here, broaden with an inhale. Exhale, Exhale. Let's find the half bow. Curl over the pelvis a little bit. Let's bring the low back towards the mat here. Cover the shoulders just above the mat here. Covering the legs above the mat. Just feel the shake in the core. Inhale, back up to boat pose. Reach through the fingertips. Keep the spine long. And easy seat. Let's cross the shins again. Rolling back up to your seated position. Just resting the hands on your thighs for a moment. Let's inhale back to our boat. Engage the core one more time. Lean back. Exhale. Soften your face. Big inhale as you lift through the heart. And reverse tabletop. Let's plant the feet flat on your mat here. You start to walk the hands behind your bottom. Fingertips pointing towards your hips. Roll the shoulder blades together. Inner elbows coming together back here. Puff your chest up. Spine is arching. And from here, round down through the hands and feet. And let's inhale and lift the hips off the mat. Now as you breathe out, push down through the feet. Lift the hips high. Last inhale, descending the heart towards the sky. Maybe you can let the head roll back some more if you want. And let's lower the hips back down to the mat. Exhale. And let's go to supine. So we're going to slowly lower our backs down to the mat. Curl the spine. Lower one vertebrae at a time, all the way down. Knees pointed up to the ceiling. And let's try a straight-legged bridge pose. Feet are hip-width distance here. We're going to press into the feet and lift the hips up. And kind of walk the feet in closer to the shoulders. Come onto the tippy toes if you want to advance this and make it a little bit more challenging. Place the hands under your hips. Fingertips pointing to the side. Just getting yourself a little bit more support. And from there, slowly walk the feet away from your shoulders. Maybe the legs can straighten all the way if you want. Feet flat to the mat. Just press the elbows into the mat, lift through your hips. Now if that's too much, go back to the regular bridge pose and bend the knees. Now let's walk the feet back in and release the hands to your side. Slowly roll it back down to your mat. Soles of the feet together for recline, butterfly. As we started the class, just bring the knees out wide here. One hand to the belly, one to the heart. One breath here. Let's bring the legs together here. Grab behind your hamstrings and rock and roll along your spine, just coming up to a seated position. So we're going to go to downward dog here. Sending the hips up and back one more time. Once we're here, let's bring that right leg up and back. Toes are pointing down. Exhale to half pigeon from here. We're going to draw that right knee into the right wrist this time. Just lay your shin bone down on your mat. Put that back knee drop down. You can scoop that back leg all the way back if you want. If the hip is kind of laying on the floor, you can deepen that toes we're heading towards. Scooting that other foot towards the left wrist a little bit. Just don't worry about how far it is. Just find a place that feels comfortable for your knee. And inhale here, lifting up through the chest. And exhale. If this feels okay, just begin to walk the hands forward, folding over that front thigh, releasing your head to the mat. Maybe lay it into your arms. Once you find a place that feels good, just soften here, release your shoulders, release your neck. Just completely relax your thighs. Thank you. palms here, tuck the back toes, and let's step it back. Okay, now right here, let's send that left foot up and away from us. Three-legged dog on the other side. Next up, find your half pigeon on the second side. Left knee into the left wrist this time. Left shin bone finds the floor. Back knee finds the floor. You can scoot this back leg all the way back, sliding it back. Slide this other foot towards the right wrist if you want. Just take a deep breath in here. And exhale from here, fold forward over the front thigh. Just release your head down. Just melt into the floor beneath you. To a seat. Swing the legs around in front. Knees pointed up to the ceiling. Feet down to the mat here. Let's go to a wide-legged seat from here. So we're just going to separate the feet out wide here. Lengthen the legs out long. Bring the hands behind your bottom here. Push down, lift the hips up so you can stick your bottom out a little bit here. And from there, place yourself right back down. And just breathe in. Your bottom ribs away from your hips, lifting up through the torso, sternum if you want. Exhale from here, let's start to hinge forward. Bring the hips, lead with the chest. As you push your chin forward, and start to crawl the hands out in front. And once you reach your max, soften your hands down to the mat in front of you with the floor. Let's relax your shoulders. Soften your chin towards your chest. Take a few breaths in here. Soften your chest down towards your knees. Take a few breaths in here. Let's walk the hands back at the legs, begin to lift your torso up. And bend the knees, place the feet on your mat. And let's find your plank again. Slowly lower the back down to the mat. And let's try fish pose. Extend the legs out long. Let's point the toes here. And let the palms face down. Slide the hands under your bottom. And from there, pinch the elbows together. Press down with the elbows and forearms. And just puff up your chest from here. Let the head rest lightly on the mat behind you. Let your throat open. Release. Let's put the elbows go up wide here. Roll your spine all the way back down. And bend the knees, feet flat on your mat. Let's find a supine twist eagle. So we're going to inhale here. Bring the knees towards your chest. Let's cross the right leg over the left. Maybe wrap the toes all the way around to come behind the left calf if you can, if you're that flexible. Or just maybe feet here. Knees towards your torso, let's exhale. And drape the knees over to the left side. Reach the arms out to a T-shape. Just gaze right. Finding a spinal twist, breathe here. And continue to soften into the shape. For a little bit more grounding, place the left hand on top of your knee here, the right knee, and anchor the legs down if you like. With every exhale, just relax into your twist a little bit more. Back down to the mat. Let's try this other side. So we're going to cross the left leg over the right. Maybe the toes can wrap behind the right calf. Just breathe in as you pull the knees in. And then exhale. Let's go to the other side. Legs coming to the right. Arms up to a T. Just gazing left. And just breathe in here. Continuing to soften into the shape. For a sense of grounding, remember you can place the right hand on top of that left knee, the top knee. With every breath out, just soften into the twist. Return to the center and bring the feet back to the mat. Let's hug both knees in to your chest. Give yourself a big bear hug, rock and roll out your spine a little bit, side to side. Give yourself a back massage. And take one last inhale here. And release down into Shavasana as you exhale. Just extend the legs out long. Feet a little wider than your hips. Extend the arms out long to your sides. Hands a little away from your torso. Palms flip to the sky. As you settle into the final pose, just invite some stillness into the body and the mind. Just be.
Like,
to deepen your breath. Pull your fingers and your toes. You're awakening the body. You can lay here as long as you like. When you're ready, feel free to roll to your right side and make your way up to an easy seated position. Thank you for sharing your practice with us today. Namaste. So there are no classes.